one of the more dramatic stories that has come out related to Satoshi Nakamoto and his potential identity being revealed, and certainly his emails being revealed. His account got hacked by a hacker, and the hacker is offering to divulge details about him if he gets like 25 bitcoins in funding from the community. So, Evan, what is the developments of this?
Oh, the story seems to be pretty dead now. It was like all anyone was talking about for like 3 or 4 days, and then it just kind of died overnight. But basically, what happened was that somehow this hacker, he goes by the name Savaged. He got a hold of Satoshi's account somehow. He didn't say how he did it. But then he started like he gained access to other accounts that were related to Satoshi, like some forum account that he used to use, and then he also got a control of the Bitcoin project on SourceForge, which is where all the updates were posted before they switched to GitHub, and like change it to something that has to do with Butcoin, like making fun of Bitcoin. And he put a thing on a document on Pastebin, a little note, he said, I'll release Satoshi's information if I get 25 bitcoins, here's my address. And he said, this isn't a scam, here's screenshots for proof. And he released two screenshots. One was of just the inbox, and it had messages dating back to 2011, and one was an actual email. It was some kind of receipt. And then he sent a message to, what's this? Hey, I gotta find this dude's name.
Roger Ver offered some a reward basically to catch this guy when it's the same hacker who hacked Roger Ver, right? And now he's hacking Satoshi Nakamoto, and the reward, the bounty reward, to catch this guy, Roger Ver is still putting that up, which is 37 bitcoins to at least deter the hacker, and that's a bigger reward than what the hacker himself would get if people paid his full 25 bitcoins for that info.
Yeah, the hacker, he sent an email to Michael Marquard. I don't know if I'm probably not saying that right, but he's an administrator on Bitcoin Talk forum. He sent an email to this guy from Satoshi's account, and then this Michael guy made a thread on Bitcoin Talk saying like, I got an email from this account. It wasn't a spoofed account. It wasn't faked in any way. It was Satoshi's actual email. And so it's pretty much confirmed that this hacker has access, and he wants 25 bitcoins, and he'll release the true identity of Satoshi. And he got 1.5, which is like $740 worth. Or no, actually, right now I just looked at $730 worth now. And he wanted 25, which is like how much? That would be like $11,000, I think. And he's just kind of died after that. Nobody's talking about it anymore.
It seems like I don't know, like why if this hacker really does have this information, I think that he'll release it eventually, right? If he has it, then it's gonna get out there somehow, whether or not he reaches his full amount, right? Whether or not he reaches the full 25 bitcoins. I think that his motivations here are also to like just illuminate the identity of Satoshi somewhat, and if that's part of his goal, then it doesn't necessarily matter how much money he gets. I think he's going to release the info regardless at some point in the future. He's just maybe biding his time, or maybe trying to make sure that people can't go after him once he releases this, because now there's a huge target now on this hacker's back as well, thanks to Roger Ver and his bounty. as well. So there's a lot of drama going on behind the scenes, and for all we know, Satoshi and the hacker could still be communicating directly, trying to negotiate, right? Because they were trying to negotiate before. And this story's not this it's not over yet. This drama's not over. And if Satoshi's identity is actually revealed, I don't think that's necessarily as devastating as some people in the community fear, because first of all, it doesn't matter if we know who created Bitcoin, because it's open source. It's been open source this entire time, and people have been building services on top of it. Anyone can work on it. You just have to get the miners to agree on your changes. And Satoshi's like relevance into Bitcoin's actual development, he has basically no relevance in that. So it doesn't matter if people know who he is in that regard. The only thing is, if people know who he is, people can either try to, try and attack him or hurt him based on like, I hurt the Bitcoin creator and get notoriety that way. But he's rich enough where he can hire his own security force, I'm sure. He's got what? Like how much are his riches? Like
There's millions of bitcoins.
millions of Bitcoin. So at a price of like, let's say $500 per Bitcoin, that's like at least $500 million that this guy has.
Yeah.
He can hire a private security force to guard him wherever he is. Or go to a different country entirely and go into hiding. He's got tons of options.
Yeah,
So I don't
well,
think that's much of a concern.
see the another thing about this is that it's not actually confirmed that the hacker knows Satoshi's actual identity. All we know is that the savage guy said that the email address was registered under Satoshi's full name, his real name, and that's all we're going on, is we're going on the hacker's word. And he got into an account, like this old forum account, like I was talking about, and posted a message addressing Satoshi himself, and he says, "Dear Satoshi, your docs, passwords, and IP addresses are being sold on the dark net. Apparently, you didn't configure Tor properly, and your IP leaked when you used your email account sometime in 2010. You're not safe. You need to get out of where you are as soon as possible before these people harm you. Thank you for inventing Bitcoin." So really, all we have to go on is the hacker's words. So I don't think that he actually knows Satoshi's identity. He's just claiming that he knows it, and then he's trying to make money off of it. He doesn't actually care if he gets 25 bitcoins or not, because anything is money to him.
Right.
He already has like $730 worth of bitcoins. I'm sure he's happy with that.
Yeah.
And so also there's, like you said, literally nothing would happen to Bitcoin except for maybe one thing, which is highly unlikely to happen if this guy actually has Satoshi's information. And there's two things that could happen from this, like in total. One, the first one is that Satoshi could have his true identity revealed along with his location, and somebody could go and physically hurt him. Which is pretty bad, you know. We don't want anybody to get hurt. And the other thing is that the hacker could have access to Satoshi's Bitcoin hoards, that he could then dump on the market and like destroy the Bitcoin price, send
But
it like into the ground.
could he get that just by having access to Satoshi's email and passwords? Like, Satoshi would be pretty freaking stupid to use the same password for his email as for his Bitcoin account, and he'd be extra stupid to hold, all of his millions of Bitcoins in one account.
Yeah, well, this hacker is claiming that he was able to get all of Satoshi's information from this email account. He's saying your docs, which means your personal information, like your documents, which is like your name, address, phone number,
Probably driver's
passwords,
license and passport, yeah.
passwords, IP addresses. But see, if he had access, what makes me really skeptical, I'm like, it's pretty certain that he doesn't actually have access to Satoshi's bitcoins, because if he did, he wouldn't be asking for 25 bitcoins in exchange for releasing his true identity. So And really, that's the only thing that could actually harm Bitcoin from this was if he somehow gained access to millions and millions of Bitcoins and sold them and then like destroyed the value of Bitcoin. But that's not going to happen because he doesn't have any of this
Or went on
information.
a shopping spree on Overstock.
Yeah, bought everything on Overstock. But
Buy
yeah,
Overstock.
I don't think he actually has any of this information. Because the hacker also said that lots of other people have gained access to this email account, and people look at it for fun, and that's why he like went snooping because he just likes looking at things they're not supposed to. So if this account was really connected to Satoshi's true identity, you would think one of these other sev of the several people who have gotten into his account before would have, released his identity because everybody wants to know who Satoshi is.
Yeah, you don't think it's not Dorian, right? We're pretty much settled on that. That is probably not Dorian Nakamoto. He's not Satoshi, right?
Yeah, I don't think he is.
Just like, what are the odds that his name is actually Satoshi Nakamoto? I think that Leah Goodman wrote, like, it's a pr I think she wrote a really good article. Like, she made a convincing case, and it was well written, but like, when you actually look at the hard evidence that they had, there was practically no evidence for Dorian being Satoshi. So it's I don't think it's him.
Yeah, one thing that really stuck out to me with that whole Dorian story was that Bitcoin is such an anti-authoritarian technology. Like at its core, it was born, from like anarchist roots. It came out of probably some old
Out
guy
of the
who's
anarchist primordial soup.
like. The guy who invented it was probably some old anarchist guy who was a cypherpunk in the 80s and 90s. And most of Dorian's career was spent working for the government.
Yeah.
So he was some kind of like computer, like coder, programmer or something, and he built a lot of programs for government, even for the military, I think, if I remember the story correctly.
Yeah.
So why would this guy who made most of his money working for the government, at the same time be so ideologically opposed to the government that he created this currency that could like basically undermine the entire thing? That's what stuck out to me with that whole thing.
Yeah. Well, like the theory that I'm sure they would push, the people who believe like Dorian is Satoshi, is like, well, maybe it's a conspiracy that that Bitcoin, the blockchain, was actually created by the NSA and all them as the perfectly trackable currency system, and it's been undercover this entire time. It's been a Trojan horse in the finance community. But yeah, probably not. I don't think
Yeah,
so.
that's pretty stupid. If you ask me.
That'd be crazy if it did happen, though. I mean, we were just used we were, if that did happen, if that was the case, we could easily just move to a different cryptocurrency that is private, that was not built by government agencies and all that crap.
Yeah, if it was really made by the NSA, they probably wouldn't have open sourced the technology.
Yeah,
Um,
yeah.
just just so just to eliminate the possibility of creating, like copycat currencies that weren't controlled by the government.